ओके, सो वेयर इज दैट? यस, सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेम्बर, इट्स अ काइंड ऑफ लाइक यू नो सेकंड लॉ ऑफ केफलर. केफलर इज वन ऑफ द फेमस साइंटिस्ट हु वाज एक्चुअली यू नो वर्किंग ऑन द प्लैनेट सोलर सिस्टम, हाउ द प्लैनेट्स रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन. सो दिस इज आई मीन ही वाज वर्किंग ऑन दैट. एंड हियर द क्वेश्चन इज द एरिया कवर्ड बाय अ पार्टिकल. नोट डाउन दिस, यू जस्ट नीड टू राइट इट. उपेंद्र, आर यू कॉपिंग एवरीथिंग दैट वी डिस्कस लास्ट यूनिट?
Yes, sir.
आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू वन आई मीन आई थिंक इफ पॉसिबल यू कैन we have to make at least one of the copy, you know, Xerox, just to
Oh.
then and make it available to all the students.
Oh.
I'll give the money for the Xerox copy, then I'll
Okay.
post that into the all the students. Okay,
Okay.
so anyway, yeah, thank you. But I have seen yesterday, like, you know, only around 10 to 15 students in the campus, but I would definitely expect more students. I was sitting in the class just motivating the students, like discussing the basic stuff, very basic stuff, like, you know, but yeah. So the area covered by a particle moving under the central, so what is actually the, you have to understand the title first. The area covered by a particle, here particle could be a planet, you can think about it. The area covered by a planet moving around the sun, which is again central force, is constant. Is saying that the area, so we have studied in intermediate that the line joining between the planet and the sun sweeps out equal area in equal interval of time. So same statement, this is the second law of Kepler. So we have to prove that area is constant. How do we prove it? So by using the central force equation, we have to make it to that. So let us consider here, this is the figure beta. The right side you can see here. Here it's the sun is there. Here you can say the planet is moving from P to Q. Okay. The angle between this, from when it moves from P to Q, the angle is delta T. Think about this, the R radial radius. The sun is located in one of the posi. This is the elliptical orbit. Okay. And you can say this is a delta R plus delta. So the particle is moving under the influence of central force. This, okay. So this figure is from the Telugu Academy book. You can see that. I mean, so what is this? A particle is moving under the influence of the central force in an elliptical orbit. S is the its center, one of the posi. So the particle travel from P to Q. So it's traveling from P to Q. In a time, how much? Here you can say in a time delta T. So it's moving from P to Q. It's moving from where to where? P to Q. From here to here in a delta time T. Okay, very nice. Then, then what happened here? Okay, so delta, so I want to calculate this. What is this, sir? This is the area, beta. Area. So how do we calculate area of this triangle? You know that, right? Half into base into height. Half into base into height. So 1 by 2, base is how much? R, which is R here. Height. Height, how do we calculate, beta? So you all know that. If you want to calculate this arc length, how do we calculate it? Arc length L is equal to R d theta, right? Let us say, if I say this is the L, L should be equal to radius into the theta. With that gives this arc. So arc length, height, this gives actually height. Okay, so R d theta. So here we are taking delta R is a small quantity. In that delta, you can think about it. So just make it this is small. But if I say this curve is L, arc length should be equal to R delta theta. So aerial velocity. So I am talking about this area. If I want to calculate aerial velocity, what should I do? I have to differentiate area with respect to time. So this is called aerial velocity. What it means and area ela change avutundi, how area will change with respect to time. So it could be, see beta, here now we are saying that P to Q, but it may be from year to year. So this area, whatever the delta t time, that must be equal to area from year to year, P to Q. So the area, if you say any equal area beta, any equal area like delta t, if you take like here 10 seconds, here 10 seconds, the area should be constant. If you take any, like, you know, I am saying that it sweeps out, and it just sweeps out equal area in an equal interval of time, and the same time lo same area vastundannadi we have to prove it. So I'm saying that here aerial velocity delta a by delta t, r is this 1/2 r into r square, okay, and I have to derivative right with respect to t. Here the left side is dA by dt, right? The right side is I'm saying that I'm making in terms of del, I'm moving the delta into d. You can do that. Delta and d, this is exact derivative. This is the not like exact. This is small quantity. So I'm moving from delta to d. So here I'm writing delta theta into d theta. But when I say delta t, this is going to be dt. So I just mentioned that.
Yes.
So here, what happened? I'm writing this guy theta dot. I can write it, right? D theta by dt, first derivative theta prime, second derivative theta double prime. So I'm not writing that. So I'm writing this 1/2 r square theta prime. So say this is the equation number whatever one, I think I mentioned one or two, doesn't matter. For central force, transverse component of acceleration is zero. Only force, only tangential force act on the only force which act on the horizontal direction of radial vector. So transverse component manaku acceleration lo manaku rendu unnai beta. ఒకటి ఏ టీటా, ద అదర్ వన్ ఇస్ ఏఆర్. ఏఆర్ ఈస్ వాట్? రేడియల్ వెక్టర్. ఏ టీటా ఈస్ వర్టికల్ కాంపోనెంట్. సో వీ డూ నాట్ టేక్ ద వర్టికల్ కాంపోనెంట్ ఇయర్, ఓన్లీ వీఆర్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ ద రేడియల్ వెక్టరే మారుతుంది కదా ఇక్కడ, ఓన్లీ రేడియలే మారుతుంది కాబట్టి వీ మోస్ట్లీ కన్సిడర్ ద రేడియల్ వెక్టర్. ఇస్ ఇట్ క్లియర్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ గైస్? కెన్ ఎనీవన్ టెల్ మీ? Is it clear, beta? It just simply, I did not do anything, beta. I just used the triangle area, then I calculate the aerial velocity, dA by dt. Then I wrote this equation. That's it. I did not do much here. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Right. So moving into the, who is drawing that? Don't do that. If you want to explain, explain. I'm ready to sit here. I'm very happy if you can write it. Who is doing that? I can see your name, but I want to point out. Okay, so you know that the this is the equation, whatever AR, if you can remember that, we got this equation AR r cap, we got this one, right? Plus a theta theta cap. So we have calculated the previous equation, AR is equal to acceleration. So we got this equation, whatever equation I am writing here. Did you see this equation? You have, right? Equation undi kada mee daggara,
or
idi manam acceleration equation lo rendu ochine kada, okate emo radial inkoti transverse theta
ochine.
So ade equation ni malle nenu ida andike can be written as known. This is already manaku telusu adi acceleration equation enta munduku vachindi adi. I am writing here. So deenni ela rayachu? How can I write it, this equation? Tell me. I want to write this form. 1 d by dt 1 by 2 r squared theta prime theta dot equal to 0. So can I write this into this? ఇది యువి అండ్ బెట ఇది కాన్స్టెంట్ బెట యువి యువి అనుకుంటే యువి అనుకుంటే యూ విల్ గెట్ ఇట్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ డెరివేటివ్ చేయండి యువి డెరివేటివ్ చేస్తే ఏమవుతుంది ఆర్ ఫస్ట్ ఐ విల్ డూ దట్ డివైడ్ ఇట్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ స్క్వేర్ ఇస్ టూ ఓకే టూ ఓకే వట్ ఐ నో నో యా ఐ థింక్ లెట్ మీ చెక్ ఇట్ what I'm gonna if I do this I have to get this one can I get it r square u or u v so what I'm gonna get if I do r square theta double prime theta then plus theta 2 r r prime okay I think this is did you check it what is this actually is it r square you can check it better this it should be r square maybe
only r undi kada sir
ade r unda
avun sir
why I am not getting that oh yeah yeah it's correct yeah it's r only okay so now I got this equation beta so what I did is r square pettanu theta prime ke em avutha theta double prime ante u dv so daniki double prime vachindi plus v ante theta prime du ante r square ki 2r but r ki r prime ఆర్ ప్రైమ్ కి అగైన్ మనం చేయాల్సి ఉంటుంది ఎందుకంటే అది డిఫరెంట్ ఫంక్షన్ కాబట్టి హ్యావ్ టు డు ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0 సో హియర్ ఐ కెన్ సీ ఆర్ ఇస్ అ కామన్ బెట ఐ కెన్ సీ ఆర్ ఇస్ అ కామన్ వన్ హియర్ దేర్ టు ఆర్స్ దేర్ ఇఫ్ ఐ టేక్ ఆర్ కామన్ ఆర్ థీటా డబుల్ ప్రైమ్ ప్లస్ 2 థీటా ప్రైమ్ ఆర్ ప్రైమ్ equal to 0 so if I bring this equal to 0 so I'm going to get this equation right okay
is it clear
is it clear let me know
clear sir
we are the bad side discuss with related this equation so so I am writing this equation into this format Why I am writing, I'll tell you. Okay, so then what I am doing here? So if I see beta, dl by dt equal to 0, can I write it? L is equal to constant. Can I write it? Change in angular momentum equal to 0. So can I conclude from this? L is constant. Because if there is no change beta there is no change in this quantity so I can say that this quantity is constant right is it clear if there is no change l so l is changing with respect to time beta d if I am saying this is zero change in angular momentum is equal to zero with respect to time if this so I can write it dl is equal to zero this will go here and dl zero is change in angular momentum if I say l2 minus l1 is equal to zero or l1 is equal to l2 is equal to l right
yes sir
right so similar way I am saying that this is let's say l or area something a so this change in of this equal to zero which means whatever this quantity is constant right is it think about this is l right so l is equal to constant so what is l here 1 by 2 r square theta dot d equal to constant so if you bring this 2 into this side so r square theta dot is equal to 2 into constant 2 into constant also constant, right? I'm writing like a k. So r square theta dot equal to k, right? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So now what we conclude now? dA by dt is equal to 1 by 2 r square theta prime. That is equal to what I am getting. What is this quantity? Tell me. It's a k, right? So this is what we, this equation we got it from previous.
From equation 1.
Equation 1 nunchi vachindi beta, dA by dt equal to 1 by 2 r square theta prime. So, but we proved that r square theta prime is equal to k, right? So, if I keep this as a k, 1 by 2 k is constant. So, we proved that aerial velocity is constant. Aerial velocity is area covered by a particle moving under the central force is constant. We prove it, right? Any doubts?
No, sir.
No, sir.
These are this is also long answer, beta. Long or sometimes like, you know, 6 plus 6 like that. They may give the A B bits like. Any doubts? If you don't have any doubts, I'll go for another question.
No doubt, sir.
So thank you. Diagram also you can copy it.
Okay, sir.
So this is a big question actually. It's again 15 marks question I have to work on. But I can complete, I can guess. What is the time now? 9, right?
Right.
So I'll try to make it, but I hope you understand. Let's see. So next, another long answer question, 15 marks or 20 marks, whatever you think about it. Very important.
Equation of moment.
I can try to finish it, but otherwise I'll stop it middle. Just remind me if you want to call it. Usually, you have enough time. If you are living close to Hayat Nagar or nearby, it doesn't take much time to come college. Equation of motion of a particle moving under the influence of central force, beta. Very, very important question. Repeated question. Equation of motion of a particle. Okay. Moving under influence of
central force.
Ready, sir?
Rational, sir.
Okay, good. Very good. So let us, equation of motion of a particle is obtained using the Newton's second law. So we know that F is equal to ma, which is already familiar. So let a particle is acted by a central force. This is the central force, beta. So you remember, right? This equation we have started when we start this lesson. Central force equation is F is equal to FR r unit, yeah. Right? So according to the Newton's second law, we know that I just mentioned it. F is equal to ma. But here r cap, since this is a vector, we have to keep r cap also. So write down these two equations.
R cap.
So can I move to next slide?
Okay, sir.
So just two equations in this slide. Central force equation is fr r cap, and Newton's second law, f is equal to ma. There's two equations I wrote here. So moving into the, it's a kind of tough, but I would say it's not so tough, but you have to, you remember this, right? Acceleration equation, we got it. R double prime, R cap, R, all this equation we had. Is it clear? We have this equation, right? Out of it, we also mentioned AR, A theta. Two, we divided into two components, radial and transverse. And only radial I'm taking here, r double. So as you know that only r cap quantities are there here, only two in acceleration equation. So that is the reason I'm telling you acceleration equation play very important role. If you understand acceleration equation, all are equal, all are easy. The other, whatever we are going to discuss next also, acceleration equation play very important role. So practice it more. So r cap So we are taking the only radial components, beta. Radius, ante ekkada ekkada aithe radius undo r cap. So what is here? R double prime minus r theta dot square. So this is a radial component. This is a transverse component. Okay. So next, f is equal to ma. I'm taking this equation number one. F is equal to fr. This is equation two. So I'm taking two equations, beta. One equation is f equal to ma Newton seconds law. The other one is central force. So we are saying that these two equations. From above two equations, both are force, right? Both are force equations. So I can make them equal, right? Can I make it one equal to two? I can do it, right? Yes. Yes, beta. I can write it, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So what is equation number one? Ma. I mean, equation number one, fr r prime, doesn't matter whatever you say, one or two, mar r cap equal to fr r cap. So I can cancel r caps both side. So I ended with right side is fr, left side what is there, beta? Ar. You have to consider this one. This is to consider it, right? So I'm writing m r cap, why whatever the acceleration component that we got it from the acceleration equation, adi indulo substitute chestunna r double cap, r double prime, I mean r double dot second derivative of r minus r theta dot square, which is called this. From here I am dividing whole equation by m, beta. When I divide m here, so this will be mm cancel. I'm going to end it with this. And the right side fr by m, I'm saying that fr by m is another force. It's not fr by m is a kind of acceleration, but still I'm saying that I'm noting down as a capital fr. Just assume that. It doesn't matter whether it's acceleration or acceleration definitely related to the, force only. So let us say this is FR without confusion. Okay. So then what I have to do it. So here it's very important question, but very, very important. Simply let me revise again. You consider two equations, make them equal and R caps will cancel and divide both sides by M. You get this and this. So you can assume this. FR by M equal to FR. You can say this. Okay. Then here I'm assuming another. Let U is equal to 1 by R. U is equal to 1 by R. Or R is equal to 1 by U. You can assume this. Okay. So when you substitute this, which equation you can go for it? Which equation? Dr by dt. No. What I can do it, dr by dt, I have to go for the derivative. Just simple derivative of, let me clear this one. So r is equal to 1 by u, beta. I have to do derivative this. When I do derivative with respect to t, dr by dt is equal to d by dt 1 by u. So what I'm going to get, tell me here. This is not t, right? It's something different function. So what I'm going to get, 1 by x ki derivative is sabhi andar ki. Anybody knows 1 by x? Suppose whenever you have the 1 by x, minus 1 by
minus x. Minus 1 by x square.
Yes, sir. Right. Dx by dt. So why I'm writing dx by dt?
Minus 1 by u square.
So if I have like this, this derivative is minus 1 by x square, right?
Yes, sir.
But if I have like this,
with respect to t, sir.
Yes, correct. Very good. So here if t is there, yes, of course it's 1 by x square minus dx by dt, you have to write it, right? Because here we are doing with respect to t. So whenever we are doing t, you have to do that derivative again, dx by dt. Similarly, I am doing here with respect to, see, u is there. U is different. Okay? U is different. So now, if I apply the same thing here, 1 by u derivative is minus 1 by u square. Minus 1 by u square. And u du by du by dt. Is it clear?
Clear, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Just focus it. Don't, it's easy if you are really. And if mass bag ochino laku, physics la definite ga 100 ka 100 osti. Mass poor unno laku, physics also poor unno. Adi okate gurtunchu. ఎవరైతే మ్యాథ్స్ ఫిజిక్స్ లో సక్సెస్ఫుల్ అవుతున్నారంటే డెఫినెట్ దే ఆర్ వెరీ గుడ్ ఇన్ మ్యాథ్స్ ఆల్సో. ఓకే, సో నౌ యూ కెన్ సీ ఇట్. లెట్ మీ చేంజ్ కలర్. కమ్ ఆన్. So here the same thing I posted again here, dr by dt, this is okay. Up to here you know whatever the copied from the previous slide. Here you have to use the cyclic coordinate, cyclic. So how can I write du by dt in terms of theta? So I can write it du by d theta, d theta by dt. Do you understand this? I mean, I think you have done in the intermediate, right? Mathematics. du by dt, దీన్ని ఇలా రాసుకోవచ్చు బిడ్డ. du by d theta, d theta by
dt.
Can we write it like that?
Okay.
I mean, if you cancel this, you're going to get this only, right?
Yes.
Changing the transformations actually. You are changing the t to theta. So both are there. So this is the way one can transfer it. du by dt can be written as du by t theta, or anything we can make it d theta by dt. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, so sir.
Same thing. Minus, it's minus also there, I guess, right? Minus 1 by u square, du by d theta is equal to du by d theta by dt. Okay, is it okay? Any doubts, please?
No, sir. Yes.
Very good, very good. Okay. From aerial velocity. From aerial velocity means we have proved previously 1 by 2 r squared theta is equal to h by 2. Right? Why? Because this is h. R squared theta, we have assumed, we got k, I think. K or H doesn't matter, any constant. R squared theta dot is equal to K. K by 2 or H by 2 doesn't matter. So R squared theta dot, we got it H or AK. So H by 2. Then if I cancel, I mean, it doesn't matter, both said, finally we proved that this is a constant. R squared theta dot is equal to H. If I substitute this, if I substitute r square det theta dot is equal to h, where should I substitute that? I can take this, and what is r beta? What is r? Let me, what is r here? R is equal to r is equal to 1 by u. If I substitute this here, 1 by u square, okay, because r square is u1 by u square, d theta by dt, theta prime is what? Theta dot is what? D theta by dt is equal to h. So I'm writing the same thing here, beta. So whatever this, we got this equation, we are expressing into theta, 1 by u square t d theta by dt. Okay, then as we mentioned, as we quoted before, dr by dt So can you substitute this? Can you substitute this in a in above equation? Can you have to substitute this equation? How? So we have to carefully have to observe it. So I'm writing as it is dr by dt, which is equal to minus is there of course minus. Here what we got it there d theta by dt, we got it like 1 by u square d theta by dt minus 1 by u square d theta by dt. What I can write it, tell me, h square, right? Sorry, h I can write, right?
Yes sir, h.
So 1 by u square d theta by dt, we have proved that this is h. So I am writing these two places in just ante h rastunna minus ki minus alane undi h du du by d theta du by d theta karas. Okay, so please stop me whenever you know not comfortable or not following me. So up to here I guess I don't know why you guys are dropping, I mean you are exiting the group, exiting the session, I'm not sure, but it's a very important question. If you don't understand, ask me, don't leave the class. Okay, so just you joining for attendance and leaving, that doesn't make sense. Okay, taking the derivation on both sides, we are doing the derivations, d square by dr, d square r by dt square, second derivative beta, like r double dot, when you do the, this is r dot, when you do the double derivative again, you get r double dot, d square r by dt square, which is equal to d by dt minus ki minus ud beta h du by dt. So id byta rasestunna d by dt ni, whatever you have this quantity is there, I'm just writing here. Endukante second on both side and beta, taking derivation on both side. So again I am doing the cyclic transferring the coordinates. Ela chestaru sir ante du by d theta d theta by dt. So ikkada chudandi ee d by dt ni first rasina beta. So what I am doing here little bit tricky to understand. So this should go first, d by d theta. Okay, then whatever we have d by dt ni, I am writing like this. I am writing first d by d theta minus h ku minus h, d by dt of what I am writing, du, u is anyway is there, don't worry. So d by d theta, d theta by dt, if you cancel this one, you gonna get du by dt only vastundi. Okay na, is it clear? Upendra, did you understand or do you have any confusion here?
No sir.
Ikkada rendu cyclic
sir, okka cheppara sir malli
enna
okka malli cheppan sir,
ikkada equation ida.
Yes sir.
Yeah, deeni second derivative chestunna idi, ante d square r by dt square avutundi. Ikkada ee d by dt రైట్ సైడ్ కూడా అప్లై చేయాలి కాబట్టి బోత్ సైడ్ అప్లై చేసాం, డి బై డిటి ఆఫ్ డిఆర్ బై డిటి నానా లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ ది, దీన్ని చేస్తేనే ఇది వచ్చింది, అంటే డి స్క్వేర్ ఆర్ బై డి స్క్వేర్ ఆర్ బై డిటి స్క్వేర్. రైట్ సైడ్ కూడా ఏం అప్లై చేయాలా, డి బై డిటి ఆఫ్ మైనస్ హెచ్ డియు బై డిటి. సో అది ఇక్కడ డి బై డిటి ఆఫ్ ఇది రాసేస్తా. దీని తర్వాత ఏం చేస్తుందంటే ఫస్ట్ డి బై మైనస్ హెచ్ రాస్తున్నాను, d by dt rasesi ikkada I'm writing from here. So remaining em undi cheppandi ikkada, what is remaining, tell me. Minus h is over, d by dt is over.
Yes sir.
Remaining em undi du by, I have to write it du by dt, right?
Yes,
is it clear? Ide okay kada ee equation undi, ee equation okay na?
Ah, okay sir.
So now what I am doing, like changing the d by dt d theta, then what I am doing is d by d theta, okay, you will keep it as it is here, and d theta by dt. Can I write it like this? Because anyway, if I cancel these two d theta, I'll get this one, right? Is it clear? Yes. Is it clear, Ainda? Is it అర్థం కాలేదా
ఓకే సార్
ఆ ఓకేనా
ఓకే
రైట్
ఓకే సార్
రైట్ నా రైట్ థాంక్యూ థాంక్యూ సో దీన్ని నేను ఏం చేస్తున్నా అంటే వాట్ ఐ యామ్ ఐ హావ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ రిమెంబర్ దిస్ అంటే 1 u స్క్వేర్ d తీటా / dt అనేది h అవుతుందని చెప్పాను సో ఇక్కడ ఏం రాయాలంటే d తీటా / d theta by dt. How much we got it? Tell me.
T dot. Theta dot.
Theta prime maintained, sir.
Theta prime.
Theta prime maintained.
अरे choose ना बेटा. Why I kept that one?
Minus h ने constant लगा दिस कौन दो?
Minus h as it is written, no? Right, right.
Dt by dt ने theta prime.
थीटा प्राइम రాయచ్చు కదా
రైట్
ఎందుకంటే ఇట్స్ ఫస్ట్ డెరివేటివ్ కాబట్టి ఐ కెన్ రైట్ ఇట్ యాస్ थीटा प्राइम వెరీ గుడ్ ఓపెన్ ద థాంక్యూ ఐ వాస్ థింకింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ మ్యానర్ బయ్య రైట్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ఫైన్ ఐ థింక్ అందరికి ఓకే కదా ఇది
ఓకే సర్
రైట్ సో ఇప్పుడు ఏం చేయాలి ఇప్పుడు నేను వాట్ ఐ గాట్ ఇట్ దిస్ వన్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఆల్్రెడీ వాట్ ఇస్ దిస్ r స్క్వేర్ थीटा प्राइम విచ్ ఇస్ ఆల్్రెడీ మనకు ఇక్కడ పైన వచ్చింది ఈ ఈక్వేషన్ ఆల్్రెడీ ఉంది I'm writing as it is here. R square theta dot equal to h. So, దాన్ని నేను what I am doing here. I have to how I got this equation. I'm trying to understand. R d square r by dt square is equal to theta dot. How much I can get it from here? Tell me. From here, theta dot is equal to which is theta by dt is equal to h by r square, right? Can I write it like that, Nana? R square theta dot equal to h. If I want only theta dot, h by r square, right?
Yes, sir.
Theta dot is, I'm writing like a, you know, first derivative, d theta by dt. So if I substitute this, so again, what is r? R is equal to 1 by u. This is going to be h u square, right? Yeah. So 1 by r is equal to u. 1 by r square is equal to u square, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I got it. So I substituted that minus. So h u square I have to substitute where I have to, what is that actually? Yeah, I'm writing like theta dot should be equal to theta dot should be equal to h u square. So when I substitute that, h becomes h square, u square is there. So is it clear up to this equation?
Yes, sir, clear.
Very good, very good. So I have to substitute in equation number 3, Nana, this one. Ekkada undo equation 3, I don't know. I have to check it. But yeah. This is a tricky but little logical question. I mean, compared to our other questions, this is kind of tough only. But if you have any mass, and the mass derivation lagane untundi, and the difficulty is basic question. Where is equation 3? I'm not sure. Let me go for next slide. I don't know where. Yeah, the first equation, Anna. Maybe it is equation 1. I don't know. Maybe equation 3. Let's see. This is equation number 3. Remember that we have got this now, right? We got this equation. This is actually d square r by dt square, right? And this and this. So we are substituting this value now there, right? Oh, come on. Almost over, beta. I'll close it. Just don't worry. So I'm writing this equation in the equation number 3. So what is going to be, tell me? So when I substitute that in the equation number 3, which is r dot, which is I'm writing IST here, you can see here. Whatever equation 3 was there, I'm writing here. Okay. So when I, you know that, right? So this one we got it in the previous equation. D square r by dt square is equal to minus h square u square d square u by d theta square. When I substitute this here, what I'm going to get? R double prime is this one. Then r, what is r beta here again? What is this value? R theta dot square can be written as theta dot, we already know that. Why? Theta dot is what? Theta dot, we proved that
h square.
Is it clear this one?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So theta, actually theta dot is h by r. So r square theta is h. Theta dot is h by r square, which is actually h u square, right?
Yes. Sir.
Why? Because r is equal to 1 by u. So, right. So this one I have to write it here. R theta dot square is equal to r theta dot equal to h u square. Does it make sense, beta? And theta dot square. Okay, why I'm writing this? Okay, let me. This one, right? Theta dot, I am substituting theta dot square. When I do square, this will become a h square h power u power 4, right? Is it clear how we got it? Theta dot, how much, beta?
Square, sir.
Theta dot, what we got it is here is h u square, right?
H u square, yes, sir.
But theta dot square, how much?
4 అవుతుంది h స్క్వేర్
u power 4 h స్క్వేర్ u power 4 1 yes, by u, why I got it, r is how much, r is equal to 1 by u, right?
1 yes. by u
1 by u h స్క్వేర్ u power 4 is equal to 4, right?
Yes, sir.
I guess you understand up to your last step, this is over almost. So now you can divide on both side by h స్క్వేర్ u square, beta. Divide and both side. Divide complete equation divided by h square. I mean, you can also divide minus, actually. Minus h square u square. So minus h square u square. This will cancel. Minus h square u square. Minus will cancel. And h square cancel. U square should be 2. And here h square u square.
Sir.
Right? So this equation going to be d square u by d theta square plus only u square left, right, is equal to minus fr by u h square u square minus is there. And this is called equation of motion of particle under influence of central force.
Sir.
Any doubt?
Sir.
Yes.
మనం డివైడ్ చేయకుండా జస్ట్ మైనస్ హెచ్ స్క్వేర్ డి స్క్వేర్ కామన్ కూడా తీయొచ్చు కదా సార్?
చేయొచ్చు. కామన్ తీసి అటు సైడ్ తీసుకుపోతే అదే అవుతుంది కదా?
Yes, sir.
యా, మైనస్ మొత్తం కామన్ తీసినా కూడా సేమ్, వాట్ ఈస్ సేమ్ పర్పస్ ఇస్ సేమ్.
అక్కడ మనం కొట్టివేత అవన్నీ చేయకుండా డైరెక్ట్ కామన్ తీసి చేయొచ్చు.
యా, యు కెన్ డు దట్. దిస్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో యు కెన్ డు ఇట్.
ఓకే.
వాట్ ఇస్ దేర్?
U square
is equal to minus d, yeah, fr అవుతుంది. దాన్ని తీసుకొస్తే అయిపోతుంది.
Minus h.
ఓకేనా?
ఇక్కడ మైనస్ h స్క్వేర్ u స్క్వేర్ ఉంది సార్, అవుతుంది.
మైనస్.
ఓకే సార్, ఓకే, బై సార్.
ఒకటి కామన్ పోయింది కదా బెటా, But still, I think I am still doubt about this, right? Amy.
Sir.
I think I have to check this equation, but whatever this equation, the final equation is correct. Somehow, if I take the common, I am going to get here u, not maybe u. I'm not sure. Maybe u. One u cancel, three there. If I take cancel, I think this is correct. Maybe I have to check the equation. I'm not sure that, but you can check it. This we'll check it tomorrow. I think there is no u square but here. Right? Okay, u cancel అయిపోయింది కదా 3 అయితే దాంట్లో ఒక స్క్వేర్ కామన్ వచ్చింది కాబట్టి ఇది వస్తుంది. ఇది ఓకేనా?
ఓకే సార్.
దీంట్లో డౌట్ లేదు కదా. ఒకవేళ స్క్వేర్ ఉంటే డౌట్ కదా మీకు. అదర్వైస్ క్లియర్. ఐ థింక్ స్క్వేర్ ఏమీ ఉండదు. ఇట్ డజంట్ హావ్ ఎ స్క్వేర్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ ఫైనల్. సో కొంచెం లెంగ్తీ అయినా బట్ రిపీటెడ్ క్వశ్చన్ బెట. ఇంకా మనకు కరెక్ట్ గా 4 క్లాసులు అన్న 4 టు 5 క్లాసెస్ వి నీడ్. సో ఎనీ డౌట్స్ ఫర్ టుడే క్లాస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టుడే క్లాస్?
నో సర్.
ఓకే.
కాలేజీలో ఆఫ్లైన్ క్లాసెస్ చెప్తురా సార్?
ఆఫ్లైన్ క్లాస్ లో